The increasing cases of influenza in Uganda in the month of June and July has created panic among the people that it might be another COVID-19 wave. However, Dr. Chiobe Henry Bosa, the incident commander for COVID-19 in the Ministry of Health and the senior public health specialist, with the outbreak and epidemics, the country does not have any COVID-19 case at the moment, although coronavirus is still a threat. Dr. Chiobe noted that the World Health Organization declared an end to COVID-19 as a global health emergency, and this means people should learn how to live with it.
This is co-saturating with the what was called seasonal viral influenza, which of course presents much the same way like COVID, and also peaking around the same time. So the two are moving together. The COVID threat remains, because as we've seen over the past three years, COVID has been very elusive.
The only way Ugandans can be safe from COVID-19 is by getting vaccinated and also going for booster doses, because people have different immune systems, as Dr. Chiobe explains.
The vaccination is still ongoing across the country. The Director General Health Services has issued two circular to the district health officers and the facilities to be able to integrate vaccination in routine vaccination and ensure that the facilities have these vaccines, the COVID vaccines.
When asked if Uganda is ready for any pandemic outbreak, this is how Dr. Chiobe replied.
The capacity for us to detect many of these viruses or all these pandemics is really high. Both the laboratory infrastructure and the surveillance infrastructure, both the facility-based surveillance infrastructure and the community-based infrastructure. Then when it comes to care, again, we have moved very far. As I said, oxygen, critical care support. At least, you remember that all our regional referral hospitals were managing COVID patients. And remember, we quickly transitioned to Mubende Regional Referral Hospital to manage Ebola. The aspects of having infrastructure, number one. Then number two, adaptability, to be able to quickly switch from one to the other. These are things, and of course also the diagnostic infrastructure, the human resources. We have moved very far.
Dr. Chiobe cautioned Ugandans on the rise of non-communicable diseases such as high blood pressure, diabetes, mental health disorders, among others. The only way for one to prevent this is by going for regular medical checkups and taking good care of themselves.
For us to be very productive in our lives, we have to be free of disease. And in this, we need to make sure that at all times, we observe prevention.
Report compiled by John Mosenzi for the news.